Hello, Danifil Games Fetches. You can't sit with us. What day is it? October 3rd?
Today, we are, for the first time on this channel, playing Mean Girls, the party game burn book, which, yeah. If y'all didn't know, is actually Dan and Phil's truth bombs.
Being evolved. Technically, I think we get a tiny bit of money every time someone buys one of these.
Does that make this an ad?
I don't think it makes this an ad,
is this hashtag gifted from us to ourselves?
We've just got to say, we own a tiny bit of this.
We're disclosing, we don't own it. We made this motherfucker. Yeah. This is some good branding. Yeah. I like it. It looks like the burn book. In case you're new to the channel and you're like, what are these people talking about?
We made a board game called Truth Bombs.
Where you basically roast your friends. You get given a card, like, what is their best feature? And I would go, his annoying personality. And then I would write that in the burn book. When you do this with more people, the point of the game is you anonymously write a roast for your friend based on the question. And then you have to guess who roasted you.
And choose your favorite.
But because it's just us, we're just going to be roasting each other in plain sight.
We're just going to roast each other and using these as cue cards because we thought it'd be fun.
Okay, yeah. Get a pen. We've got a selection of roasties here that are either ones that we wrote or they're Mean Girls puns.
Yes, and like Cards Against Humanity, we're going to decide who we think is the best.
We just have to mutually agree which was the funniest slash most insulting.
You ready?
Yep.
Roast begins.
Oh, this one's perfect. Very Danifil reactor, Phil isn't on fire.
Yes.
What did you think when you first saw this person?
Ooh.
2009.
Okay.
We meet offline.
We meet online.
No, we meet offline.
Offline, having met online.
Well,
yeah.
When I first saw you, what I thought was, damn, he has the hair of Pete Wentz and the posture of Mr. Burns.
I did have
he has that real online hunch.
I know, I've got to really stretch
it out. I was expecting him to be like,
hey.
I'm amazing for like, YouTube and his daddy.
Like, I think it's also a nervous thing. I feel like I try and reduce my height if I'm a bit
hello
nervous.
There.
Thanks. I thought you looked like a Poundland Anthony Padilla.
What the fuck? What did I do to you?
Poundland.
Poundland?
I'm just saying.
Poundland Anthony Padilla.
Maybe smart price. People that are not from the UK.
It's a dollar store. What do you think it is?
Well, it's just Poundland. Poundland.
Oh God, let's go to Poundland.
Poundland. Anyway, that's not what I was thinking.
I'd go to Poundland with Anthony Padilla. All right, fuck, you win that one. Okay, straight up. The next one, what do they keep in their hair?
Okay, in their hair.
What are they hiding up there?
What is beneath the
curls?
What
is their secret?
You straightened your hair so much, there must be tiny beetles that just have affixed to your scalp by now. Like the creatures in Amber that are just preserved.
A 1,000-year-old fossil has just crystallized and all the hairspray have fused to my head with straighteners.
But that's not my answer. My answer was the gay thoughts he repressed until 2019.
They were just waiting to come out, and then they came out with the curls.
Like you.
Oh, and for yours, I put all of the thoughts that fell out of his utterly vacant head.
It's fair.
There they are. Because they're not in your head. No brain detected.
Look, it's hard being this pretty.
Oh, fuck off. Take it.
Yes! What outfit sums them up as a person? Ooh.
So many outfits over these eras.
There's so many of yours I could roast. I'm ready.
Come on.
The leather shirt. I think that sums it up because
shut
you
up.
Tried really hard, but you didn't succeed. It was edgy, but bad.
And sticky. For Phil, I put the cheese suit because he's pale, stinky, and unsupportive.
It is not supportive.
Flimsy.
Things fall out.
One-dimensional.
That suit.
Cold.
Yes.
Cheap. I could keep going on here.
You can have it.
Thank you. If they were having a party, what would they serve?
Quack. Sorry. I would never normally say that word. I couldn't help myself.
Got a sense of that.
Yeah.
Got Dystopia Daily demonetized for that.
Stunning social cunt.
What's up? It wasn't even a C! It wasn't even a C!
Ooh, this is hard. You'd be serving bitter bites. Because everything Dan likes, he's like, ooh, let's get this off the menu. And it's always like,
oh,
mushroom,
look at that. I want some radish.
Sand,
yes.
Ash. Also, you're quite a bitter person.
I think Phil would serve absolutely nothing in terms of looks and snacks because he ate them all.
Wow. I can't argue with that.
The cupboards are barren.
That was a close one, but I'm going to give it to you.
Really? I think you should have it.
Bitter bites?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, this one's a lovely end of year reflection one.
Okay.
Looking back on us, how would you sum up the time you have spent with this person?
Okay. Just thinking back to all the stuff that I'd sum up.
Yeah, I know what I'm gonna say.
I'm gonna be honest with this one.
Yep.
Loud and exhausting. It's true. We, like...
I regularly break the sound barrier.
You do. Whenever I sit next to you in a gaming video, it makes my ear ring. What about me?
Danitus. I would sum up the time I've spent with you as like being a carer for a roadkill possum.
Why? I'm more useful than a roadkill possum.
Just not really functioning, cognitively or physically.
Yeah.
Deranged, feral, leaves all the doors open, rummages through stuff. Unwanted, a pest.
Okay, you can have it. The imagery was perfect.
I told you it was just gonna be factual.
What is the dumbest thing they've ever said?
This is gonna be hard. Wow, okay.
Yeah, I've got some.
Anyone that's watched this channel is gonna have reams of this ready to go. There's an actual factual answer for this for you, Phil. Phil was talking about how he only likes the top half of cupcakes,
yes.
And no one likes eating the bottom half, so he wants to open a tops only bar.
I might open a cafe that's called Tops Only, and then it just sells the top of cupcakes, and then you can just go and grab that.
I think that people might come in thinking it's a gay bar and they will be grabbing something else, which might be a branding issue for you, but...
That was great without context.
Look, it would be a great place to go.
But the answer is, the dumbest thing you've ever said
yeah.
is GNU.
Oh, don't remind me of that.
Phil, in wildlife, the name of which South American mammal is unusual in that the first two letters are the same?
GNU.
Correct answer is llama.
First two letters are the same.
I heard it wrong.
Is farmed for its wool. No, no, not llama. GNU.
Are they even
who
farmed
needs
for their wool?
£3,000? No.
I heard it wrong.
It's the dumbest thing I've ever said, Phil.
Subscribe for more content.
The dumbest thing I've ever said is subscribe.
You didn't come back, did you?
I'm a liar. That's tough. Who do you think earns that?
You burn me more with the GNU. You can have it.
That is real. I mean, you were on BBC One saying that. Oh, this is great after the last video.
Yeah.
If this person was to start a fashion trend, what would it be?
Ooh.
What is their style legacy on culture? I think there's a very clear answer to this.
I've got one.
If I was to start a fashion trend, what would it be, Phil?
It would be ninja with daddy issues core. You dress really weirdly and a little bit gay and a little bit depressed.
A ninja with daddy issues. Oh my god, it makes so much sense.
I know.
I said that the trend that Phil's gonna start is the claw hand.
The claw hand? Is that a fashion trend? Or is that a real
watch every A-lister hitting the red carpet with the...
Look!
They're gonna be doing this.
Look, I've got a problem with my body. We shouldn't be laughing at it. Oh no, I'm just gonna chop my hands off.
Stand like a normal person! I'm gonna give you that one. Oops. Ninja with daddy issues, very- are you trying to pin my foot?
Yeah, I just dropped it on my mouth.
How are you gonna take me down?
Okay, ready?
Yep.
If they were calling in sick, what would their excuse be?
Okay. Sorry, I just feel like I'm gonna sell an axe to a child today. I can't come in.
Do you know Dan's excuse to anyone is always grandma related and it's always really obscure?
I'm not joking.
Dan, you could just say, sorry, I can't come, but you're always like, sorry, my grandma, she needs help with these stairs and I need to go and then there's an elevator and I'm like...
It invokes the sympathy.
Immediately everyone knows you're lying if you tell too much information.
Fuck yeah. Hey Phil, what's my excuse for calling in sick?
I just need a hiatus.
I'm sorry, to protect my emotional well-being.
I just need
a hiatus.
Hiatus.
I may go for 5 years.
Yeah.
But when I come back, it'll be worse than ever. I think you would say, I've Googled my symptoms, and apparently, I have a terminally fat ass.
I mean, sometimes it's hard to get through a thin doorway.
Thickitis.
Yeah, it's a real problem.
Hips don't like lichulosis.
I don't know where that butt came from, because they have quite a slim figure, and then it's like,
but donker.
Hello.
Phil, I'm gonna give that to you, that was way too real. Next one. What is the last thing that they look at on their phone before they sleep?
Oh, I don't want to know. I bet there's some cursed things in your incognito.
Are you making yourself laugh?
Just planning.
I think the last thing that Phil looks at before he sleeps is Phil X NordVPN Wattpad fix.
Why? Look, I love NordVPN.
He wants the money. He wants protection.
I want protection.
Phil's got a dirty, gaping browser just wide open, and that Nord's gonna come in and it's gonna lock it up.
Damn,
it's gonna lock it up like a good little boy.
They are never gonna sponsor us again.
It's gonna protect your passwords. He's not gonna let anyone in that thing.
No.
And if you ask him just right, he'll give you that special link. I think this is what Phil thinks about.
Oh my god.
In his capitalist fantasies. What do I look at before I sleep?
Tony the Tiger hole pics.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Hole pics?
I just...
What did Tony do to you?
I don't know. I just thought it'd be funny.
Frosted flakes. That's how I got frosted.
Barry was a low blow. You can take the VPN.
All right, one more. Right. One more. I'm starting to get slightly... That urge of when you've been roasting each other too long, it's like kind of funny and you're getting a bit offended.
Yeah.
Might get stabby with this pen in a second.
I'm at that level.
This is perfect to end this with.
Sure.
Phil. What will their last words be?
So upon death, what are we gonna say? Dan, I'm dying. I've got one last thing to say.
Oops. I guess Amazing Phil is Amazing Kill.
Oh, that was good.
And what is the oops? Could be anything.
I mean, anything could have slipped onto something.
What?
I don't know what I mean.
Oh God. Yeah. Phil, what will my last words be?
Wow, it happened. I am on fire. I'm sorry.
So, wait, I am burning to death.
Yes.
And I take a moment to do an ironic look to camera and go, wow, it happened. I am finally on fire.
Even if there's no camera, you will do that.
No, for fuck's sake, take the goddamn card.
Yes!
Okay, Phil wins. It has been a spattering of roasts.
Wow, we really roasted each other.
Oh God, the book is burned. The book is fucking cremated.
There is no more book.
That book was burnt more than an LGBT novel by a Texas high school.
Oof. Oof. I'm not even gonna laugh because it's true. That was fun. Thanks us for inventing
well,
that.
Well, yeah, who wrote these questions? Damn. Yeah. Well, we can't take credit for half of those, but the other half, sure. Yes, we take all the credit for it. Amazing game.
Well
the
done,
burn book.
Everyone.
Don't know what's roasting me harder, you or this incredibly itchy Danville Christmas sweater.
Mean Girls the Musical is coming out. Do we need that in our lives? Will it
yes,
be good?
Yes, Phil.
Yes.
We are part of the brand
Make a
now.
Sequel. Make another game. That was fun, though. I still like you. Don't worry. I feel like sometimes with roast people, like, do they hate each other? It's like, no, we're just playing.
I want you to write in the comments one of the questions that was on the screen and then your answer for how you would roast one of us.
Yeah.
That'll be a fun comment section.
I'd like to read through that.
Yeah. Just give us a like because we literally just murdered each other on YouTube for your entertainment.
Yeah.
There were some deep cuts there.
So deep.
We mind all the trauma.
Bellas, watch the last video. We're getting close to the end. I hope you're enjoying the ride.
Oh God.
Bye.
Bye.